front drawings were done by the same artist who does the job for Masterbox and MiniArt. Kit number is CB35140. CB35140. The kit was released in 2014, so it's rather new. Some close-ups of the very nice drawings. The backside of the box shows a sprue map. Then the instructions for the build and a painting guide. Bronco gives us 4 paint manufacturers to choose from. That's not very much, but it's more than other companies do. The price I paid for the kit is okay for what's in the box, because there are decals for the insignia included. I won't talk about each part in this kit. I mainly bought it because of the cameras and the typewriter. They'll be used for another dio that'll be settled in Poland after the campaign. Anyway, we'll take a closer look at some parts. All I say about those also goes for the rest of the kit. What we can see here is that the folds of the uniforms look realistic. They're crisply molded and once painted they'll show nice shadows and highlights. Now for a closer look at this chap here. His face looks absolutely gorgeous for a plastic part. He's got real eyes and even nostrils. A joy for good figure painters. Here you can see how well the parts are sculpted and molded. This shows that it's possible to make figures without flash and pronounced seam lines. Even the hands will be easy to clean up and they're usually the worst bits on most figures. Another nicely sculpted head. I was just full of praise for the hands of the previous figure and then this here. Maybe Bronco did this to make sure that modelers can practice removing flash and seam lines on the most delicate parts of a figure. The revolver and holster appear to be okay, but a closer look reveals that the part is somewhat thin and doesn't look too convincing. And here's this fellow's head. Again nicely done, but I've got a strange impression. Let's take a closer look at the end of this video. And now for the parts that were the reason for buying this kit. Several film and photo cameras come along with this kit. There are tripods and a typewriter. As it was to be expected, there are many tiny and delicate parts for the assembly of those items. They look very nice and I hope they still do after the assembly. Just another quick look or two of the figures. There's a second sprue with cameras and typewriter. That means I can steal what I need from this kit. There'll still be enough to build at least some of the figures the way it's meant to be. And now for the impression I talked about. I don't know if you see it the way I do, but to me all those faces almost look the same. They're really nice and well detailed, but they look as if they were brothers. There's really not much of a difference between them, and they don't look like the heads on the box art. Well, it's rather unlikely that you use more than one or two of them on a dio. If you do, you should try to make them look distinctive by your paint job. Last but not least, the decals. They come in an extra bag and they look very good. They're in register and they are thin. It shouldn't be too difficult to apply them with a tiny bit of a solvent and a setter.